Welcome to this episode of Star Wars Declassified, where we look into different facts and stories revolving around the Star Wars canon universe and lore. In today's Declassified, we'll be taking a look at the Death Star Superlaser, how exactly it operates, and answer the age-old question regarding the safety of the two-man crew executing it. The Death Star Superlaser, one of the galaxy's most feared superweapons during the Galactic Civil War, which aim was to strike fear and keep countless systems in line. It was the primary weapon of the Death Star battle stations, powered by 8 kyber crystals. Laser beams generated from these crystals were focused, and then combined into a single blast of incredible power, capable of destroying an entire planet at full output. The idea for this was devised due to the Sith controlling the Empire, following the plans of the ancient Sith who, according to legend, also used massive kyber crystals to create super weapons of mass destruction. The super laser was operated by 8 different stations, each using separate kyber crystals to power the laser, and each of these stations had separate crews whose job it was to make sure the laser was prepped for ignition and appropriately timed with the other stations. To fire the super laser, the command was always given by the highest ranking individual aboard the Death Star. That order to fire was then communicated from the main bridge to 8 separate stations. At each station, the crew at the weapon control room would then receive the message. This crew contained several Imperial weapons technicians and Death Star troopers. Once they had received the message, their primary job was to get the super laser ready to be fired. And then, once their duty was complete, they gave the other crew the go-ahead, whom were positioned right across the weapon control room and right beside the super laser. This small operating station was made up of only one Imperial weapons technician and a Death Star trooper. The trooper's job was to monitor the levels, while the lone weapons technician pulled the trigger to activate the super laser. Considering the distance these two had to the super laser itself, it was actually never an issue despite rumors of radiation poisoning or the like, and the reason for this is incredibly simple. All because the Death Star uses kyber crystals like a lightsaber to create the super laser. And just like of lightsabers which don't give off any heat unless you touch them, then it's the same case here. The two-man operating crew need not worry about any risk of radiation and are safe from any harm. Of course, just as long as they don't fall into the actual laser. And that'll do it for this episode. If you enjoyed what you saw, please like and share it, along with subscribing to the channel to not only support it, but keep up with Star Wars news, gaming, and canon lore released every week. And consider following me on Twitter and Facebook to never miss out on the latest Star Wars related content. And if you want to support the channel, do check out our Patreon page. Or if you want to continue the conversation, join us on the official Silo Discord server. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.